Yes, yes, Kenya. Tamu sana, tamu sana, tamu sana, yes. President Uhuru Kenyatta met William Ruto today at State House Nairobi in preparations for William Ruto's swearing in tomorrow. And that did not go on well with Babu Owino. Taking to his social media accounts, Babu Owino had this to say. Babu Owino, thank you, Uhuru Kenyatta, for keeping your word to Ruto. Your body language tells it all. It was a long con. We will still reach where we are going. If we could not hunt with a dog, we'll use a cat. And then Babu Owino shares that photo of President Uhuru Kenyatta and William Samoei Ruto. Yes. In this video, I want us to understand the games Babu Owino is playing here. Because Babu Owino is the only close associate of Raila Odinga directly blaming and attacking President Uhuru Kenyatta. All other Raila Odinga allies are silent. They are not directly attacking President Uhuru Kenyatta. In fact, about 2 days ago, Otiende Amolo, Rareda Member of Parliament, who was also Raila's lawyer at the Supreme Court, blamed Uhuru Kenyatta's men. In fact, he never blamed Uhuru Kenyatta, but his men. And some few days ago, Maina Kamanda, who was also seen as a very close Uhuru Kenyatta ally, blamed President Uhuru Kenyatta directly, in that Maina Kamanda was saying Uhuru Kenyatta was not accessible. So in this video, I want us to understand what is going on behind the scenes and the games Babu Owino is playing here. Before we do that, in case you are watching us for the very first time, subscribe, give this video a like. Yes. Babu Owino, just like other Raila Odinga supporters across the country, are hurt. Babu Owino is still hurting and he has so far not healed. So Babu is very bitter with President Uhuru Kenyatta, for he feels the president had the power to make sure what happened at Bomas never happened. Babu Owino strongly feels the president had the power to act, but he never acted. So Babu Owino is most likely angered as a result of that. And Babu Owino, being a politician and an ambitious politician, he's out to achieve some political objectives and goals, which I want to explain here. The first objective, Babu Owino is using the occasion to build his political brand, in that he knows that a good majority of Raila supporters lost faith in Uhuru Kenyatta the moment Uhuru Kenyatta failed to crack the whip at Bomas. A good number of Raila supporters lost faith and trust in Uhuru Kenyatta. Babu Owino is trying to build his political brand among those Raila Odinga supporters. And he's doing that deliberately for succession politics, in that Babu Owino wants to position himself as a possible successor to Raila Molo Odinga. And if you look at the reason why a good majority of Kenyans are supporting Raila Odinga, was because Raila was brave and fearless. Babu Owino is trying to project that kind of image, a brave and fearless kind of a leader. And that is really working for Babu Owino among Raila Odinga supporters. He is being seen as a brave and fearless leader. Yes, Babu Owino is winning that war. And as I talk, there are even some rumors from some political quarters that Babu Owino is among the top politicians or other leaders who might one day succeed Raila Amolo Odinga. There are such talks from some political quarters. And indeed, if you look at Babu Owino, he is coming out as a promising leader. A future promising leader. The only dent on Babu Owino's image is his marital status. As much as he's trying to reach out to Raila Odinga supporters, his marital status is actually making some people not to embrace Babu Owino. His marital status. So Babu Owino's first mission here is to build his political brand among Raila Odinga supporters for a possible, rather as a possible successor in the event Raila Odinga retires from politics. The second objective, Babu Owino might be seeing the actual truth that Raila himself or his close associates are not ready to say or to talk about. Maybe Babu Owino is just talking the truth that these Raila associates are not brave enough to talk about. But just as I've been saying in this forum, it's only Uhuru Kenyatta and Raila Odinga who know exactly what happened. And personally, I cannot speculate on behalf of Raila Odinga. As long as Raila Odinga is silent, I take that Uhuru Kenyatta never betrayed him. Because Raila Odinga is not somebody known to be silent when an injustice has been committed against him. But as long as Raila Odinga is silent, I cannot blame President Uhuru Kenyatta for betraying Raila Amolo Odinga. The president, at least from what we have seen, stood with Raila Amolo Odinga to the last minute. And just some few days ago, the president also made it very clear that Raila Odinga will remain his leader. So I don't want to speculate as to whether Uhuru Kenyatta betrayed Raila Odinga or not. It's only time that will tell. The truth will just come out one day. And as long as Raila Odinga is silent, I cannot authoritatively state whether Uhuru betrayed Raila Odinga or not. So Babu Owino is out to achieve those two missions and goals. First of all, to build this political brand among Raila Odinga supporters. And then secondly, Babu Owino might be stating the truth that Raila's close associates are not brave enough to say. Yes, Babu Owino is now just achieving those two missions. And as I conclude, ladies and gentlemen, William Ruto will be sworn in tomorrow. He is going to be the president, and I know it's a very painful affair for the millions of Kenyans who know that William Ruto never won the election. It's a very painful affair for them, and I know quite a good number of them will not even be interested in trying to see how Ruto will be sworn in as the president. I know they're not interested in that, and most of them might not even watch those things. But as William Ruto will be sworn in as the president, William Ruto should listen to wise counsel. The people surrounding William Ruto will not tell him the truth. William Ruto should listen to contrary opinion. A good majority of Kenyans, one reason that a good majority of Kenyans hated William Ruto is because William Ruto is deemed corrupt. And those surrounding him are also deemed corrupt. So William Ruto, upon being sworn in as the president, he should start by cracking the whip. Those surrounding him who are seen as corrupt, let Kenyans see those people being taken to court. If Ruto do that, or rather if William Ruto will be able to do that, some Kenyans will embrace William Samoei Ruto. Let me stop it there, ladies and gentlemen. But just as I did state, in case you are watching us for the very first time, but so far you have not yet subscribed, subscribe, give this video a like. And to our fans and subscribers here, I'm very much humbled, very grateful for the kind of support you are giving me here. God bless you. God bless Kenya. To any other person who wants to have a discussion with me or to share information with me or even to support this channel, I've pinned my number on the comment section. Contact me through the number, or you can channel any kind of support or donation to the number. Let's meet in our next analysis, ladies and gentlemen.